Very good afternoon. Welcome to Sikh TV News. Hello, I am Akanshi Singh. So here are your daily afternoon dose of news from Punjab and across the world. So let's begin the bulletin starting with the news headlines. Reconsidering the education expenses of children of martyrs. Finance Minister Manpreet Badal handed over the provincial assembly record to Speaker Rana KP Singh. Newly elected SGPC President Gobind Singh Longowal today held the first meeting. Families of four missing youth are urging to help and bring their sons back to home. Now it's time for the British to apologize for the Jallianwala Bagh massacre said by London Mayor Sadiq Khan. Rehearing for Ayodhya case fixes on February 8. The Punjab and Haryana High Court has issued a notice to the state government over closure for thermal plant. US President Donald Trump will recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman said she would reconsider the cap on the education expenses of children of martyrs. Speaking in Ahmedabad, she said fee capping was the part of the 7th Pay Commission of recommendations. She also said that our government is never against the soldiers. In September, the Department of Ex-Servicemen in the Ministry of Defence decided to cap the fee at Rs. 10,000 per month, impacting around 3,200 students in the schools, colleges and professional institutions. The forces raised an objection on October 10, but the ministry turned it down. Now the forces under the banner of the Chairman Chief of Staff Committee have sought removal of the cap. Under the scheme, rolled out in 1972, the tuition fee of children of martyrs or those disabled in action is paid by the ministry. With time, political affiliations in Punjab have changed, but perhaps governance hasn't. The Congress and the Akali Dal were coalition partners in the Punjab Provincial Assembly, governed by the Unionist Party in 1946 to 1947. It may only be in 2009 that the Punjab government has passed an order saying that the minimum education qualification of clerks to be recruited by the government should be graduation. However, in 1940, 225 clerks recruited for the higher and district judiciary by then government headed by Sir Sikandar Hayat Khan were all graduates. The man behind arranging this valuable slice of history from Lahore, Finance Minister Manpreet Singh Badal and AIS Officer R.K. Kaushik will also be giving copies of these volumes to the Haryana Vidhan Sabha and Punjab University. After assuming the charge, the newly elected SGPC President Gobind Singh Longowal today held a meeting for the first time with his staff members after paying obeisance at the Golden Temple here. Stressing on transparency, dedication and mutual cooperation, he held the accountability of every staff member towards their duties. Addressing the officials, he directed them to make adequate arrangements for the upcoming events to mark the Prakash Purb of Guru Gobind Singh, scheduled at Takht Patna Sahib, which is Guru's birthplace, on December 25. He also told to observe Shahidi of Guru's sons during the same week. Later, he also met Akal Takht Jathedar Gyani Gurbachan Singh, though the details of these meetings could not be procured as Longowal maintained a distance from the media, apparently due to several controversies erupted over his visit to the Sirsa Dera prior to 2017 assembly elections and was declared at Tankhaya by the Akal Takht for overruling the Hukam Nama against the Dera head. There has been no respite for the families of the six youths who went missing while trying to make an illegal entry via sea route near Bahamas for 4 months ago. Holding a press conference here today, four of the families of these youths hailing from Jalandhar, Kapurthala and Hoshiarpur alleged that the police were yet to arrest the cop-turned-travel agent Sukhvinder Singh of Mendipur village and his accomplice Ranjit Singh Rana, who had duped them ₹52 lakh on the pretext of sending their sons to the USA. We have not heard from them since August 2 this year. We urge Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh and External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj to help us bring our sons back home, said by Subedar Shamsher Singh, the father of Inderjeet Singh of Mukeriya village. Well, this is all what we have in today's edition. Stay tuned for the more updates and let's have a look again on the headlines again. reconsidering the education expenses of children of martyrs. Finance Minister Manpreet Badal handed over the provincial assembly record to Speaker Rana KP Singh. Newly elected SGPC President Gobind Singh Longowal today held the first meeting. Families of four missing youth are urging to help and bring their sons back to home. Now it's time for the British to apologize for the Jallianwala Bagh massacre said by London Mayor Sadiq Khan. Re-hearing for Ayodhya case fixes on February 8. The Punjab and Haryana High Court has issued a notice to the state government over closure for thermal plant. US President Donald Trump will recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel.